Okay, so let us start with the class. So in the last class we were studying about this function point metric, and there we studied that this function point metric computation, it's a three step procedure, where in step one we first compute the unadjusted function point, and in step two we refine it using some parameters, and again in step three we again refine it further so that finally we get that. So from step one we have learned how we compute a separate input, which one we consider as separate output, number of inquiries, files, interfaces, and in step two we have studied how we refine those parameters, that is this input, output, inquiry, interface, file, everything has few values based on the factors that whether it is a simple one or it's an average one or complex one. So according to that we multiply it with the number of interfaces or number of files or inputs we have. So we actually refine the formula by multiplying it with the respective values. So instead of everywhere multiplying the number of inputs by 4, we multiply it by 3 in case of simple, in by 4 in case of average, and by 6 in case of complex. So this is the step 2 procedure. Now step 3 procedure is, so in the final step we do what, several factors that may impact our overall project size, they are considered, and they are considered in doing the refinement of this UFP which we have just computed from step 2. So parameters which influences the project size, that can include high transaction rates, it can be scope of reuse, it can be response time requirements, so like this. Albrecht, who has invented or who proposed this metric, so he has identified 14 parameters which can influence the overall development effort for any project. Now this list of these parameters I will just write it down. Now each of these 14 parameters, they are assigned with a value from a range between 0 to 6. 0 means that that parameter is not present or it doesn't have any influence. So 0 means that it is not present or that parameter has no influence, and 6 means that it has a strong influence. So according to the influence of these 14 parameters in the project, so they can have a value ranging from 0 to 6, and the resulting numbers, they are summed. Whatever we are getting out of these 14 parameters, they will be all added up, and at together we will get the total degree of influence, that is our DI. So I will sum all these parameter values and I will get a DI value. Now TCF for the project is computed, TCF. TCF means technical complexity factor. This TCF is calculated and this TCF is multiplied with the UFP I have from step 2 in order to give or finally give the FP. Okay, so the equation is that TCF is calculated as 0.65 plus 0.01 into DI. Okay. This is the formula according to which the technical complexity factor for any project is calculated. Now, this TCF parameter or factor, it will express the overall impact of the different project parameters on the development effort. So this is the formula using which the TCF of any project is calculated. And since TCF varies from the range 0.65 to 1.49, so automatically DI can vary from the range 0 to 84, whatever it is. And finally, we have the function point metric as the UFP which we calculated from step 2 into the TCF which we calculated from step 3. This is one formula, this is another formula. So first we do for the UFP. We go with the number of inputs, number of outputs and all that. Second, we refine that formula according to the simple average complex values, value which we have. According to that, we do the multiplications. And then another 14 parameters which are defined by this Albrecht who invented this function point. Those values of 14 parameters are given from the range of 0 to 6 according to how it influences your project. And by summing all those parameter values, I get the degree of influence DI. And by using this formula, I put the value of DI in this formula, I get the TCF. And then this TCF value and the UFP value, which we have just got in step 2, we multiply and get the final function point metric value. Fine. So this is the way we calculate the final function point metric computation. Is this clear? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. So what are those parameters which we just talked about? So requirement of reliable, I will just write it down. So like this, which I will share in your notes, like this, there are 14 parameters which the scientist or the research scholar, that person has suggested, and it was also incorporated. So based on these 14 values, the value it have from a range from 0 to 6, it is assigned by the project manager, and according to that, the project size is computed for our specific projects. Okay, now I will give one case study so that you can understand how this thing is done. So everyone, please listen carefully to this case study. Okay, suppose you are asked that you need to determine the function point measure of the size of a supermarket software. Suppose you are making a supermarket software and you need to find out the FP for that. Fine. So the supermarket needs to develop a software in order to encourage its regular customers. So what is the type of the software? The customer, he will supply his or her address, then phone number, and then suppose driving license number, DL. And each customer who registers for this scheme, he will be given, each customer, once we register for anything, what we are given? We are given a number, unique number. So each customer will be assigned a unique CN number, customer number. There will be a unique customer number by the computer. Now, based on this generated customer number, a clerk, based on this CN, the clerk, he will manually prepare a customer identity card. So he will prepare a customer ID card after getting the manager's permission. After getting signature or permission, whatever you do. Fine. Now a customer can present, suppose a customer, he can show his CID card. He can show his CID card while checking out. After the purchase. And what will happen? The value of the purchase, it will be credited to his CN. Fine. To his customer number, the value of the purchase as a points, it will be credited, just like it is done in any big bazaar or other. So at the end of the year, the supermarket will award gifts to paying customers who will make the highest purchase over the year. So in that year, so every year they will check this thing, points and they will check, look for 10 customers who had made the highest total purchase over the year. And also it will award a 20 So also the customer who has, every customer who has made the purchase above 10,000 over the year, they will award a suppose 22 carat gold coin. Okay. And these entries which are done against the CN, it is updated at the last day of every year. Okay. So after the prize winners lists are generated, again these entries are again set back to zero. So this is your case. That is, you need to make a supermarket software. So the customer will supply his or her address, phone number, driving license. Then each customer will give in a unique customer number generated by the computer, and based on this computer generated CN number, the clerk, he will manually prepare customer ID cards and get it signed by the manager. So customer, after the purchase is being made, so at the counter he will show his ID card and the value, the total points of that purchase, the value of that purchase, it will be credited against his customer number. So at the end of the year, what the supermarket manager will do, he will see that who are the 10 customers who had made the highest purchase. So the purchase value is credited against each customer number. So he will just look for the highest value against which customer number, and he will accordingly get everything, his address, phone number, he will get everything, his address, phone number, everything from that. So after that, he will give gifts to 10 such customers who have made the highest total purchase, and also to all the customers who have made, among these who have made above 10,000 rupees purchase, he will give a gold coin. And now after this prize winner list is generated, again the entries for all the customer, the entry values will be all reset on the last day of every year. So this is our entire project which was to be developed by the company who are maintaining this thing. And according to this, we will determine the complexity of the development, and we will determine the function point metric. So given this case study, what is your first step? So from the examination of this entire problem description, how many inputs, how many outputs, how many files, how many interfaces do you get? Anyone, how many inputs do you get? How many input will be there to this system? One input is the residence, address, telephone number, driving license. That is, details of a customer is one input. Then another input is anyone? One input will be the details of the customer which we are providing it to the computer, and another input will be or can be another input is, so you need to first find out the number of inputs. So one input was details of the customer, and another input is, while you are doing this checking out, you need to provide your CN number. So your CN number is inputted to this machine, and against that the purchase you have made is automatically, the value is inputted. So two inputs are there, details of the customer for getting the CN number, and while you are making the payment or during the checkout with your staff, you are inputting the CN number, you are giving the card to your the staff, he is inputting the CN number, and against your card all the purchase value is being credited. So two inputs. What are the number of outputs? How many outputs are you getting? How many outputs are you getting? Anyone? How many outputs are we getting? First of all, we are getting automatically, when I'm giving all the details of the customer, this scheme will assign a unique CN number, right? So a unique CN number by default is one output. Fine. Then whenever I am giving CN number as input to my system, it will show me some values. It will show me the purchase values. So that is also one output. Purchase value while I am entering. When at the end I want to see how many persons are there who will give me the above the highest purchase, right? So 10 customer names I am getting as output who has made the highest purchase, right? Another can be, again it will give the names of customer who has made purchase over the year above rupees 10,000, right? And again, you set the entries like when you are setting the entries to be reset on the last day after the prize winner list is generated. So prize winner list, it is also generated by the computer based on all the inputs it has. So these are the five things which we got getting as output from this entire software system, right? What are the files? Number of files? What are the number of files? We are requiring two files now. One file we are requiring for storing the customer details, and another file we are requiring for storing our daily purchase record. Otherwise, how that values will are getting assigned? Daily purchase records, right? So we are storing two things. We are storing our customer details. From these stored customer details only everything is being generated, and we are storing this daily purchase record, right? There is no interface. So number of input is 2, number of output is 5, number of files is 2. Fine. Another two things are required: number of inquiries and number of interfaces. right? Number of inquiry is, we have only one inquiry. We have only one inquiry, that is we want to see that who are the customers, who are the customers, 1 minute. We want to see that who are the customers who are making names of those customer, top 10 customers who has made the number of purchase, highest purchase. And after getting the highest number of names of 10 customers, and beside that, when we get the amount of their purchase, top 10, from there only I can just find out that who is that person above 10,000, right? So for finding this thing, name of customers above 10,000, I do not need a separate query. In the same query itself, I can find out that who are those customers that among the total amount of highest purchase has made above 10,000 purchase. So my number of inquiry is just one, right? Number of inquiry is just one. Why is it just one? Because just I need to print name of top 10 highest purchase customers over the year. And what are the my number of interfaces? My number of interfaces is zero. I do not need to interface with any other modules. From this module only, from the customer details, customer number, customer identity card, and the purchase value he has made, all these things only in this system only I can find out everything. I do not need to interface with any other external system, right? So if this is my entire value, so accordingly, what my was my unadjusted function point calculation? Number of inputs into 4 plus number of outputs into 5 plus number of inquiries into 4 plus number of files into 10 plus number of interfaces into 10. So this was my unadjusted function point calculation value. For the first step, number of inquiries, number of inputs, number of outputs, number of files, number of inquiries, and number of interfaces which are required for this specific software according to this case study. Everything I have found out. So accordingly, using the formula, number of input into 4, number of output into 5, number of inquiry into 4, number of files into 10, number of interfaces into 10. So I will find out the UFP, and if I do this calculation, it gives me 47. So from step 1, I have the UFP value 47. This 47 value I will refine in step 2 and step 3. So is it clear to you people how from this case study, how for a particular software project you need to calculate or make rough assumptions of how many input, output, file, interfaces, inquiries will be there, and accordingly you need to find a roughly approximated UFP number? Is this thing clear to you? Yes or no? Yes or no?
Ma'am, outputs are 5, then why you have written 3 there?
So just 5 minutes is just remaining. I will quickly share with you the attendance so that you can mark your attendance. Okay, so everyone please mark your attendance. And those who are being able to mark their attendance one by one, after marking the attendance, you may leave. And if anyone has any query, you may ask me now. And after the marking the attendance, you may leave the class.
मैम हेलो हेलो